This week's space news kicks off with a Falcon 9 rocket set to launch two lunar landers in mid-January. Next, Space One, a Japanese startup, launches their Kairos rocket. Rocket Lab advances the in-space manufacturing sector by delivering the second spacecraft for Varda Space. We'll then learn about the latest developments with the Starlab Space Station. And finally, Vast Space has secured two private astronaut missions to the International Space Station with SpaceX. Okay, let's get started. Double commercial lunar lander missions in January 2025. Firefly Aerospace and Japan's iSpace are putting their moon landers on the same Falcon 9 rocket. The rocket is scheduled to launch in mid-January 2025 and will have a 6-day launch window. Once launched, the two lunar landers will be placed into a translunar injection orbit. This will be iSpace's second ever moon mission. For Firefly, they'll be using their Blue Ghost lunar vehicle. I've reported on this lunar lander before, check out the video for details. NASA has awarded Firefly two Blue Ghost missions already, the first launching next month, and the second scheduled for 2026. As this video was being made, we heard that Firefly had just been awarded a third mission with NASA that will launch in 2028. Today we are excited to announce that in approximately 1 month, iSpace's historic Mission 2 will be launching and we will make our second attempt to land on the moon. iSpace founder and CEO Takeshi Hakamada said in a statement, "As organizations, companies, and missions around the world are aiming for the moon, iSpace will continue to capitalize on our achievements during Mission 2 to lead the world in the development of the lunar economy," he added. "We hope you will join us. See you on the moon." Their first landing attempt in 2023 was not successful. It was later determined that the vehicle made a hard landing due to the spacecraft software miscalculating its altitude. iSpace's Mission 2 will send an upgraded lander, named Resilience, to Mare Frigoris, which is Latin for Sea of Cold. It's a large basaltic plain that lies 60.5 degrees north of the lunar equator. Resilience carries five payloads: a water electrolyzer, an experimental food production module, a deep space radiation probe, a commemorative alloy plate, and Tenacious, a 10-inch or 26-centimeter micro rover. Resilience is taking a slow but efficient path to the moon, arriving 4 to 5 months after launch. If everything goes according to plan, the lander will operate on the lunar surface and deploy Tenacious, which will collect moon dirt and gravel under contract with NASA. The other lander in the Falcon 9 rocket is Firefly's Blue Ghost lander. This is a brand new lunar lander design that marks Firefly's entry into lunar landers and deep space travel. The first Blue Ghost mission, which is called Ghost Riders in the Sky, will deliver 10 science instruments and technology demonstrators to the lunar surface for NASA via the agency's Commercial Lunar Payload Services program. Blue Ghost will be released from the Falcon 9 before iSpace's Resilience lander and arrive around the moon first, reaching lunar orbit 45 days after launch. The lander will touch down in Mare Crisium, a basaltic basin about 17 degrees north of the lunar equator. Blue Ghost will operate payloads for a complete lunar day, that's 14 Earth days. We'll keep you informed on this launch and both missions. Okay, on to our second story this week. Launch failure of the Kairos rocket from Space One. Space One is a Japanese space startup that is hoping to be the first Asian private commercial company to reach orbit. This is their second attempt, with their first attempt also ending in failure earlier this year. The second launch proceeded normally at first, but according to a later press conference, things started to go wrong about 80 seconds into the flight. The thrust vector control failed at T plus 1 minute and 20 seconds. That's just 10 seconds before first stage burnout. First stage separation, second stage ignition, and fairing separation did occur. After the vehicle strayed off course and veered to the west at about 100 km altitude, the flight termination system was triggered. This was at T plus 3 minutes and 7 seconds. The maximum altitude reached by the vehicle was 110.7 km. According to Space One, the first stage solid rocket motor burn was normal. Many of the staging goals Space One had set itself were reached. And although this was not a successful launch, The company has learned a great deal about the vehicle and will hopefully fix those issues and try again. Okay, onto our third story this week. Rocket Lab has delivered the second and completed the third spacecraft for Varda Space. Rocket Lab has delivered its second Pioneer spacecraft to Vandenberg Space Force Base and finalized production and testing of a third spacecraft. Rocket Lab has a four spacecraft contract with Varda Space. The Pioneer platform developed by Rocket Lab hosts a 120-kilo re-entry capsule developed by Varda Space. When in orbit, manufacturing of pharmaceuticals starts, and once completed, the capsule separates from the platform and returns to Earth, where the completed chemicals can be recovered and used. Rocket Lab's Pioneer platform provides vital systems, including power, communications, propulsion, and attitude control, enabling the capsule's precise positioning and safe return to Earth. Rocket Lab also supports Varda's operations with mission-critical services, such as launch support, commissioning, and re-entry logistics. The first Pioneer spacecraft launched in 2023 and successfully supported crystal growth of ritonavir, a HIV-AIDS treatment drug, inside Varda's capsule. After 8 months on orbit, the capsule deorbited and safely landed in Utah in February 2024. To learn more about this mission and about Varda Space, check out my video on them. The second mission, scheduled for the first quarter of 2025, will perform similar operations, with the capsule deorbiting and landing at the Kyniba Test Range in South Australia. Varda CEO Will Brewey said, "This mission is another step towards high-cadence re-entry. Soon, re-entry will be as common as launch." Okay, on to our next story. Major progress with the Starlab Space Station, according to NASA. Starlab, a NASA-supported commercial space station, has successfully achieved four critical milestones in its design of its future space station. The progress is part of a NASA Space Act agreement that Starlab signed in 2021. The agreement includes milestones covering habitat structural testing, systems integration, integrated operations, and a structural test plan. These milestone achievements are great indicators to reflect Starlab's commitment to the continued efforts and advancements of their commercial destination, said Angela Hart, Program Manager for NASA's Commercial Low Earth Orbit Development Program. "As we look forward to the future of low Earth orbit, every successful milestone is one step closer to creating a dynamic and robust commercialized low Earth orbit. The Starlab station can be deployed with a single launch. The station is comprised of a large habitation and lab module with a smaller service module attached for power and propulsion. After construction of the modules, Starlab will thoroughly test the structure to ensure it can withstand the rigors of launch and in-space operations. These tests include welding checks, proof pressure testing, and static load assessments. Components will be pressurized to exceed normal operation levels to confirm structural soundness, while static loading test evaluates the system's responses under applied loads. Starlab is also preparing for a safety review before the year's end. This ensures the design conforms to human spaceflight requirements. NASA is actively supporting the development of multiple commercial space stations, including Starlab, through both funded and unfunded agreements. Once the design and development phases conclude, NASA plans to award services to commercial operators and will send NASA astronauts to these commercial stations. There has been some concern expressed about how much funding is available to support commercial space stations. While a number of space startups and more established companies or consortiums are vying for the coveted NASA award, it may only be a single company that wins. That could likely see the other companies fail, since there isn't enough demand to support multiple commercial space stations. At least not yet. The other possible contenders are Axiom Space, which we will be reporting on soon as they are reconfiguring their space station at the request of NASA. Vast Space is also a major contender and will be privately building their Haven 1 station and hoping their larger Haven 2 station will win the NASA award. Speaking of Vast Space, let's move on to our next story. Vast signs agreement with SpaceX for private astronaut missions to the ISS. Vast Space has signed a deal with SpaceX for two private astronaut missions to the International Space Station, pending NASA approval. Varda is partnering with SpaceX to fly two Crew Dragon spacecraft to the ISS on what NASA refers to as private astronaut missions, or PAMs. These are short-duration missions to the station and serve as a stepping stone to future commercial space stations. Max Holt, the CEO of Varda Space, said, "Enabling payload and crewed missions to the ISS is a key part of Varda's strategy, allowing us to further our collaboration with NASA and global space agencies. These missions not only strengthen our expertise in human spaceflight operations and collaboration with NASA, but also position Varda as a leading contender to develop the next generation successor to the ISS." Gwynne Shotwell, President and Chief Operating Officer of SpaceX, said, "I'm excited to work with Varda as they build more opportunities and destinations for more people to travel amongst the stars. These Varda missions will only go ahead if NASA approves them. All four previous private astronaut missions have been from a rival of Varda, Axiom Space. It could be that Varda sees Axiom achieve practical experience dealing with astronauts traveling to and from space stations will give them an advantage coming up to the crucial award for a commercial space station that NASA will be making in the coming years. Having the same experience as Axiom, plus relationships with NASA, will help NASA consider Varda as a trusted and reliable partner for human spaceflight." Varda said its agreement with SpaceX for Crew Dragon missions to the ISS is in addition to an earlier contract with the company for the launch of its Haven 1 module, and at least one Crew Dragon mission to it. Haven 1, scheduled for launch as soon as late 2025, will be able to support up to four short-duration visits, helping Varda test technologies and gain experience for its larger Haven 2 space station it is proposing to NASA's Commercial Low Earth Orbit Destinations program. For more about Varda and their ambitious space station plans, click on the video that should be showing on screen now. Okay, that's it for this week. We'll keep you informed about these space startups in the coming months and years. Be sure to like and subscribe to see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon!